By watching this video, you'll understand how to set up governance configurations using the control tower of SAP Build and ensure that SAP Build adheres to your organization's IT standards and governance policies. Apart from the overall governance features that SAP BTP offers, like identity management, security authorizations, and roles and access limitations, the control tower within SAP Build lets you define the configuration aspects of your SAP Build projects. The control tower can be accessed from the SAP Build lobby directly. As an administrator, you'll have access to these features you see here. The control tower serves as the configuration base for your governance operations. The areas you see here reflect different actions you can configure. The type of tenant you require will depend on your specific use case. You can tailor these needs within the Tenant Configuration section, where you can define your tenant, establish governance rules, and configure environments. To implement automations that send messages and use designated destinations, you'll need to configure these settings in the Backend Configuration section. If you need to utilize automated processes, you'll need to configure the agents responsible for running these tasks. The Agent Configuration section is key for managing that. Let's do a deep dive into the different areas. If you want to gather information about the current tenant or change its general settings, simply navigate to Tenant Details. In Tenant Details, you have the ability to change the tenant type and the details of your tenant. Additionally, you can add a name, description, or link to access the tenant. This information will be displayed in the shell bar for easy access and quick assignment. A practical use case here would be naming the tenant for different project stages, such as Project Alpha Development, Project Alpha Testing, or Project Alpha Production, for easy identification and management. To ensure that users are performing tasks correctly and within policies, you have the option to configure additional approval flows. These can be set up for project creation and transport requests. Even with full development access, users might create projects that disrupt operations. Adding an extra governance layer on project creation and transport management minimizes this risk. Governance can be enabled or disabled on both create or promote independently. When you enable governance for desired actions, a default governance approval process is activated, and it's fully customizable to meet your specific needs. You can customize the governance rules to notify respective stakeholders when users promote or create projects. As an IT administrator, you can decide which tenants require these governance rules. For example, any project creation or transport in a governed tenant triggers an approval process involving designated personnel, such as yourself or the Center of Excellence team. Introducing the default governance flow. It includes an approval process with notifications containing project details, approval, and rejection alerts, and an event for project continuation. This flow activates once you set up a governance rule for a tenant. Here you can configure the recipients of these notifications and approval flow. You can also decide if the project requester must fill out a dedicated questionnaire, which gets forwarded to the approver for decision making. Of course, this flow is customizable, allowing you to add any additional actions you need. Once you deploy the governance flow, it will be deployed in a dedicated governance environment so that it can't be triggered or executed by others. Only IT admins have access to this environment. Once configured, activate the governance rule for actions within the current tenant. Your settings will now be live, triggering governance flows and actions for project creation or promotion. This is then the request tile. In here, IT admins have a complete overview of all governance flows and projects within the system or tenant, while business users can view only their own requests. Here you can see the project details, the request type, status, submission date, requester, and completion date. As a quick note, an SAP Build process automation and difference environment must be set. Under this tile, you can manage different environments within your tenant. These environments are configured to secure access to deployed processes, automations, monitoring, logs, agents, and other resources. Within the control tower, you can grant specific users and user groups granular access to monitoring, viewing logs, deploying, executing, and administrating. For example, you could set up environments for different lines of businesses, like an environment for HR, an environment for finance, or for dedicated teams. Tailor them to whatever makes the most sense for your needs. And then only assigned people called members will work on these environments and will set up their projects there. This is the detail view of one environment. In this view, you can edit the environment settings, such as its identifier and description, and you also have the ability to delete it if necessary. By sharing the environment, you can grant access to specific employees you need to work within, ensuring only authorized users can interact with the environment's resources. Let's move on to the backend configuration section. In this area, you can define destinations, set up your mail server, configure a cloud ALM, and establish external authentications. For example, if you need to automate email notifications for system alerts, you would use this section to configure the mail server and specify the destinations. This ensures that your automated processes are properly set up to send messages to the right recipients and connect with the necessary services. Destinations are predefined endpoints in SAP Business Technology Platform for securely storing connection details such as client credentials and keys. The destination tile lets you manage and whitelist these endpoints for SAP Build, ensuring appropriate use. For example, to consume SAP system APIs, maintain destination in the BTP cockpit and whitelist them here. The list displays destination names, authentication types, and associated environments, offering a clear overview. This feature simplifies managing the connections, ensuring secure and monitored access to multiple SAP systems. Next, let's move to the agent configuration section. Here, you can manage and monitor your agents and their tasks. Use this section if you plan to consume automated processes, as it is the central hub for overseeing automation and resource use. For example, if your agents monitor system health and gather data, you can register new agents, update systems, and adjust configurations for optimal performance. You can also perform mass registrations and manage external IP safe lists. In this section, you'll see the agents within the current tenant. You'll be able to view their names, who logged in on them, as well as their status and attributes. This way, you can secure your agents with different applications. This overview provides an instant snapshot of all ongoing activities, allowing you to react quickly to any necessary changes. With the Actions menu, you can configure each agent as needed. And by clicking on a specific agent, you can access all the detailed information connected to that agent, providing a comprehensive view of its status and activities. The Agent Update tab allows you to ensure all agents are updated to the latest version, thereby maintaining compatibility and enhancing security. For instance, within this tab, you can see comprehensive details such as the current versions of agents, their delivery dates, available platforms, status, activation dates, and agent counts. Keeping your agents up to date is essential for security, performance, and compatibility. This feature ensures you can deploy updates efficiently across your agent network. Finally, the Others section. In here, you can define currently API keys, which can be used in your tenant. The API keys tile allows you to manage API keys for authenticating and authorizing API calls. You can generate new keys, manage existing ones, and revoke those that are no longer needed, ensuring security. For example, if a third-party analytics tool needs data from a tenant's projects, you can generate an IP key specifically for read actions. This way, the tool can access the necessary data without affecting other workflows. And that concludes the tour of the control tower in SAP Build. Each of the configuration options is designed to provide you with robust control and management capabilities, ensuring your system is secure, efficient, and tailored to your needs. Thank you for watching, and we hope you find these tools valuable in your day-to-day operations.